Well, what I'm going to do is show you the basic materials that you will need to paint successful watercolours. Let's start, first of all, with, I suppose, the most important part of kit, and that's the paints themselves. This is a paint box that has lots of mixing space. It has a little tray here in the centre that holds the colours that you're going to need. And if I just go through the colours one at a time, there's Windsor Yellow, Raw Sienna, Light Red, French Ultramarine, Cerulean Blue, Windsor Blue, Burnt Sienna, Neutral Tint, Alizarin Crimson, Cobalt Turquoise Light, Windsor Red, and Windsor Violet. Now, I find that with those 12 colours, I can paint any picture anywhere in the world. That's all I need. I don't need any more than that. Those are artist quality colours. Now, in artist quality, it means that they're more finely ground pigment and they're far superior to student quality colours. They come in either full pans, or what are known as whole pans, or half pans. There's nothing different between the whole pans and the half pans. It just means that this fits into a smaller box, where if you're using a lot of paint or doing a lot of painting, you're going to need to have the bigger pans, and that's more economical for you if you're doing a lot of painting. They can either come in 14mm tubes or 5mm tubes. Again, they're all artist quality paints as opposed to student quality. And even though they're a little bit more expensive, it's worth spending that extra couple of quid to get the colours that you want. Sometimes there's a little bit of difference in the price, other times there's a lot more in the price. It all depends on what the source material is, the likes of cobalt or turquoise or stuff like that. So I would say stick to the artist quality, forget about the student quality. You'll see in the paint box here that there are lots of mixing space. Now that's essential whenever it comes to painting in watercolours. You have large deep wells here for mixing large washes. You have flat plates on the other side here for mixing medium-sized washes. But in the middle, you have got lots of little areas. And that's so important whenever you're mixing the colours throughout a whole painting that you have enough space to do that. Some people, I've seen them in the past using a plate to mix your colours. There's nothing worse than that because you squeeze your colour out onto the plate. Whenever you're finished, you want to wash the plate. You're washing your colours down the sink. This way, you can put your colours out. Whenever your colours are running out, you can replenish them from the tubes straight into the little pans. And they can stay there for a day, a week, a month, a year. It doesn't really matter. Every time you open your box, all you have to do is freshen your colours up and off you go again. So always get something, a paint box with lots of mixing space, so that you'll not be looking for space during the painting. So that's one type of box. Let's just set that to the side for a moment. There are a couple of other variations that I would use. This is a little field sketcher's box. Absolutely dinky little thing. It's got a thumb loop on the bottom, and that's so that you can slip your thumb through that. I don't want to turn it upside down or everything will fall out. You can put your thumb through the little loop on the bottom, and then with your brush, you've got your colours, your water container, your palettes for mixing the colour, and a little bottle there that is useful for holding. There's also a little brush in here, which is very fine for doing little bits of detail. You can see it comes to a very fine little point. But that's a dinky little thing to have. If you're just going out to sketch a few things, but you're not really interested in doing a full painting until you come back to the studio, I find it invaluable. Those are all artist quality paints. And again, the paints are always set out in the same format, in four blocks of three. Windsor Yellow, Raw Sienna, Light Red, and so on, down to Windsor Violet in the bottom right-hand corner. There are other variations of that. Again, another dinky little box, got lots of mixing space on it. But ideally, whenever you're painting with a small box like that, you'll want to have some other mixing palette available to you. And I find that something like that is just about right, because it has deep wells. It has got wells that will hold a lot of wash. So for your larger sky washes and your medium washes, that's ideal.